tightest port. Because it starts moving and shaking, then it starts getting weak.
The base is now secured with more zip ties than there are elves at the North Pole.
We use about 3,000 zip ties.
Then, the additional 24 levels are connected like a giant erector set.
All right, so now we need 10. The next row with the wood pieces leaning inside.
It's starting to get a bit of a bounce to it.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that's nothing.
As the build continues, so do worries about the weather.
Our biggest concern today is definitely the wind.
The taller the tree grows, the more intensely the high winds shake the structure.
Very much 20 feet up, and you can see that whenever the wind hits this tree, it sways a little bit. And in fact, anytime anyone walks up and down the tree, it just bounces.
The winds are about 30, 35 miles an hour.
If the winds get any stronger, it will be too risky for the volunteers to be on top of a wildly rocking tree.
When they start hitting 40, 45 miles an hour, it's too dangerous to be on the tree.
Coming up, will the dangerous winds sway the volunteers out of finishing the lobster trap Christmas tree? Every year, the citizens of Rockland, Maine honor their local lobstermen with an extreme build. A 35-foot-tall Christmas tree made entirely out of lobster traps.
How do you stay safe on the trap tree? You stay on the ground.
In spite of bone-chilling, tree-shaking winds, the citizens of Rockland are so determined to put up their 35-foot-tall lobster trap tree that they'll risk their lives in the process.
When they start getting 40, 45 miles an hour, it's too dangerous to be on a tree.
If people were up on that tree, they want to be up there because it's dangerous. That's what the fishing community is all about.
So how does a lobstering town really rock and roll into the Christmas season? By aiming their sights on the Moby Dick of lobsters. A giant 8-foot-tall lobster tree topper.
This is just a guy that...
Nice and easy.
If it started to come down, it could actually hit people on the way down.
That thing was swaying. You know, it's held together with zip ties.
The heart and soul of Rockland is now in place.
We decorate it from the top down using over 400 feet of garland, all wrapped in lights.
Now for the final touch. It's time for all of the local lobster families to make their mark.
Every single one of those buoys represent a different lobsterman who's fishing in Penobscot Bay.
I made sure that my pink buoy is at the top of our enormous lobster trap tree.
Yes, I fly a pink buoy. I take a lot of crap for it, too.
Working on the tree today was definitely a tribute to not only my father, to everybody who goes out there and tries to catch lobsters for a living.
Thanks to the daredevil work of the builders, the entire town of Rockland turns out for the festivities.
I'm really excited to see the tree light up.
All right, are you all ready to light the lobster trap Christmas tree?
Because it's big. It's enormous.
The lobster trap tree is 25 feet wide and 35 feet tall.
With over 3,000 zip ties holding in place over 150 lobster traps, 480 feet of garland, 3,000 lights, and 150 buoys, the lobster trap tree is as big, bold, and rough and tumble as the town it represents.
The tree symbolizes the community because it has different buoys from different lobstermen.
It endures and it stands tall and proud and strong.
It's only natural that a lobsterman might risk his life for a Christmas tree.